Dear learners, you are going to watch the configuration and comparison of various network topologies for the various network dynamics using Cisco Packet Tracer in this video. The aim of the experiment is to configure and compare various network topologies using Cisco Packet Tracer. The objectives are to configure the following network topologies. Which include the bus, star, mesh, ring, dual ring, tree topology, and hybrid topology. The second part of the experiment will help you to compare the network topologies. Now, first scenario which we are going to construct in the Cisco Packet Tracer will be for the bus topology. Here in this topology, you can see the bus configuration is formed with the help of the switches. The switches are connected, each of the switch is connected to a computer. So the switches are forming here the bus configuration. In reality, we use a common coaxial cable as the backbone cable, and we use the T connections to connect the computers to the common backbone cable. So the computers are connected to the common backbone cable with the help of a T connection to configure the bus topology. So we are going to configure the bus topology in Cisco Packet Tracer in this manner. We are going to show the connection of the computers to the switches, and the switches are connected in the bus form. Each of the computers will be configured with the IP address so that we can see the communication between any pair of these devices. Now, in order to construct the bus topology, we need a common bus cable and N drop lines. For example, if you want to connect N nodes in bus configuration, then we need a backbone cable, and N drop lines. These are the N drop lines, and this is the common backbone cable. In bus topology, the network becomes slow if the size of the network becomes large. This is the drawback of bus topology. Then each of the device here in bus configuration should have one input output line so as to get connected with the common bus. The installation and reconnection of bus topology is difficult because of these T connections. Bus topology is cheap to configure, and the fault identification is difficult in this bus topology. The bus topology follows the multipoint configuration. Here you can observe that each device is connected to the other devices. So this forms this multipoint configuration. Privacy is not maintained in bus configuration as the signal travels through a common bus cable. Now let us look at the star topology. In star topology, we are going to take one central switch and we are going to connect the computers to this central switch. We are going to assign the IP address and gateway on each of these computers so that we can see the communication established between these computers via this switch. So for testing the communication between any two devices connected in star, we need to assign the IP addresses on each of the computers and also the gateway IP address. In star topology, there is a central hub to central switch or central hub to which the computers can be connected. computers can be connected. And the drawback of the star topology is that if the central switch fails, then the star topology fails to operate. Now each of these device in the star connection should have one input output line so as to get connected with the central hub. No privacy is maintained in the star topology as the information is collected by the central hub. So no privacy is maintained. Then installation and reconfiguration of bus star topology is simple. Fault identification is simple in case of star topology. And star topology follows the point-to-point configuration. Star topology follows the point-to-point configuration. Now let us see the mesh topology. In mesh topology, every device, every node is connected to every other node in the network with the help of the peer-to-peer connections or the point-to-point connections. So mesh topology also follows the peer-to-peer connections or point-to-point connections. And in mesh topology, privacy is maintained because point-to-point connections are used. There is no central hub over here. The central hub always collects the information from number of devices. Here there is no central controller. Every node is connected to every other node with a point-to-point connection. So privacy is maintained in the mesh topology. But the drawback of the mesh topology is that it is very expensive cost-wise, and the fault identification in bus topology is this mesh topology is easy. It is easy to identify the fault. If there is a fault in a particular link between the two nodes, then it can be easily identified, and reconnection of this devices in the mesh topology is easy. The number of input-output lines with each device over here is equal to n minus 1. The number of input-output lines required with each of the node is n minus 1. If there are n number of devices connected in mesh, the number of input-output lines required with each device is n minus 1. Let's take the example of this node. This node is connected with all other nodes, right? So this switch is connected to this switch, to this switch, to this switch, to this switch. So there are total five switches over here, and each of the switch needs 5 minus 1 input output lines to get connected to every other switch. We have taken switches to connect the computers because these computers directly cannot be connected in mesh topology like this, because the computer has got only one interface. So each of the computer cannot be connected to the remaining four computers directly. So we connect the computers with the help of the switches here, and the switches are forming the mesh configuration over here. In order to test the communication between any two devices, let's say this device and this device, using this mesh topology, we need to configure the IP address and the gateway IP address on each of these devices which are connected in the mesh topology. Now, the next topology is the ring topology. In ring topology, the common backbone connection is formed in the form of a ring. The switches are connected in the form of a ring over here, and each switch will be connected to a device. So in ring topology, the total number of lines required to connect n number of devices will be equal to n. If you observe the number of links over here to connect 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 switches together in ring manner, then the number of lines required are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in order to connect 6 devices in ring configuration, you need 6 lines. In general, to connect n number of devices in ring topology, you need n lines. Only the mesh topology requires the maximum number of lines. That is the drawback of the mesh topology. It requires large number of links to connect the number of devices in the mesh form. But ring topology requires only n number of links to connect the devices in the ring fashion. The line configuration which is followed in the ring topology is the multipoint configuration. Again, this node is connected at multiple points in the network, so it forms a multipoint configuration. The fault identification in ring topology is difficult, and the installation and reconnection in ring topology is easy, and the privacy is not maintained in the ring topology because the message passes through the common backbone ring, and so privacy is not maintained in the ring configuration. Now the drawback of the ring configuration is that if a particular link breaks over here, let's say this link breaks, then the packets or the information cannot be passed on through this path. If this device wants to send some information to this device, then the path is broken over here. The information can be passed on to the other path, but if both these links are broken, then the link structure will fail. Or even if switch is not working over here, that ring structure will fail. So to overcome this drawback, the dual ring configurations are used. In dual ring configuration, there are two backbone rings. So even if one ring structure fails, the other ring structure can take up and the communication can be continued with the help of the other ring structure. Now, in order to observe the connectivity between the devices, let's say this device and this device here, we need to assign IP addresses on these devices so that we can test whether these two devices can communicate via this ring topology or not, dual ring topology or not. Now, next type of topology is the tree topology. In tree topology, we always see that it forms an open loop structure. There is a root node. The root node has got the child nodes, and these child nodes again have the child nodes, and in turn these child nodes will have the child nodes. So this structure forms an open loop structure. These nodes are the leaf nodes, and the topmost node is the root node. This is forming an open loop structure. The tree structure does not have any closed structure. It is always an open loop structure. And here you can observe we have formed the switch tree topology with the help of the switches. Each switch will be connected to a computer. And to test the connectivity between any two devices, we need to assign IP addresses on these devices. Now, next topology is the hybrid tree topology. As the name suggests, it is a combination of more than two topologies or combination of more than one topology. A star can be combined with a ring topology, or a ring topology can be combined with a mesh topology, and so on and so forth. So here you can see the hybrid topology, which is formed by combining all kinds of topology. Here you can see the ring topology is formed with the help of the switches. And in this section, you can find the bus configuration. In this section, you can find the star topology. In this section, you can find the mesh configuration. And this part illustrates the tree topology. So this hybrid topology is illustrating the combination of ring topology, star topology, mesh topology, tree topology, and the bus topology. Such combination may be observed in the internet, because internet is connecting billions and billions of nodes together. So such hybrid topology is observed in our common internet communication, internet structure. Now, after performing the experiment on the Cisco packet tracer, you'll be able to compare the network topologies with respect to the total number of links, the privacy, the number of input output lines with each device, the installation and reconnection, whether it is difficult or easy, and you are going to compare the topologies with respect to cost factor. You are going to compare the topologies with respect to the fault identification and isolation, whether it is easy or difficult in each of the topology, and then you are going to compare what kind of line configuration each of the topologies is using, and then you are going to compare these topologies application wise. Now, as discussed earlier, mesh topology requires the total number of links as n into n minus 1 by 2. For example, we are connecting 5 nodes like this in mesh configuration. Each of the node is connected with every node in the network. So for connecting 5 nodes in the network, how many links are required here? 5 into 5 minus 1 divided by 2, that is 5 into 4 divided by 2, that is 10 links are here. If you count the number of links over here, you will get the count as 10. So it becomes very difficult if we want to connect say 50 nodes in a network, because to connect 50 nodes in a network, 50 into 49 divided by 2, these many number of links, which is equal to 1225 links, which is a very large number, is required. So mesh topology is very complex and it's installation is difficult, and cost wise it is expensive. Installation is difficult, reconnection is also difficult in mesh topology. And in order to connect every node with every other node in the network, for n minus 1 number of links are required in general to connect n nodes in mesh topology, right? So n minus 1 IO lines are required to connect in connect every node with every other node in the mesh configuration. Privacy is maintained in mesh configuration because the point-to-point links are used in mesh configuration, and it is easy to identify the fault because of these point-to-point configurations, point-to-point links. So fault identification and isolation, even if isolation is easy in case of mesh configuration, let's say a particular link is broken between the two nodes. Even if this link is breaking, the communication is possible via the other path. So the fault can be isolated easily in the mesh configuration. And the line configuration used in mesh topology is the point-to-point configuration, and applications of mesh topology are in the regional telephone offices. The regional telephone offices, like your MTNL offices or BSNL offices, are connected in the form of a mesh like this. Then next is the star topology. For star topology, we have seen that to connect n number of devices in the star form, we need n number of total links, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Then privacy is not maintained in star cockpit configuration because every device is going to send information to the central controller, central hub. So privacy is not maintained in the star configuration. And the number of input-output lines is required in the star configuration is 1, which is required with every device in star configuration. For example, if we consider this node, then it is connected with the star with the help of only one line. This node is also connected with the help of only one line to the common controller here. So only one input-output line is required to connect the devices in star configuration to the central hub in case of the star configuration. Then installation and reconnection is easy in case of star configuration. If a particular link is broken over here, then this node can be removed and then replaced, and that link can be connected again easily. So reconnection is easy in star configuration. Star configuration is less expensive. It is very easy to identify fault in star configuration. If a particular node is not working here, it is easy to identify the fault in this non-working node easily. And the line configuration followed in star configuration is point-to-point configuration because every device is connected to every other device with the help of a point-to-point link. This is point-to-point link. Star configuration is used in local area networks and also in the high-speed local area networks. Now, bus configuration. In bus configuration, there is a single backbone cable like this to which the devices are connected. These are connected to a common coaxial backbone cable with the help of the T connections. But in Cisco Packet Tracer, we are going to consider the connection of these switches in order to show the common backbone configuration, right? And in order to set the bus configuration, we need a common backbone cable and n drop lines are required. These n drop lines are required for connecting n number of devices in bus configuration. N number of devices can be connected in bus configuration with the help of a common bus cable and n drop lines. Then there is no privacy in bus configuration because the signal will be transmitting along the common bus. It can be captured by each of the devices which are connected to the common bus. So no privacy is maintained in the bus configuration. Now the number of input output lines with each device is equal to 1 in case of bus configuration. Each device can be connected to a common bus with the help of a single line, so only one input output line is required with each of the device. Then it is difficult to install this bus configuration because the T connections required in the common coaxial cable is very difficult. Then cost of installation of bus topology is low, it is less expensive. Then identification of fault is difficult in bus. If there is a break in a common bus, then it is very difficult to identify the location of that break in the common bus structure. So fault identification is difficult, and even the isolation of that fault is difficult because if there is a break in the common backbone cable, then the communication will stop among the devices through the common bus, and that fault cannot be easily isolated. There will be need to change the entire backbone cable in that case. Then line configuration is multipoint in case of bus configuration, and nowadays bus configuration is not used because it becomes very slow if it is used in very large size networks. If we try to use the bus configuration in very large size network, then the length of the cable will be increasing and it will be very difficult to identify the faults in that bus configuration. And if the length of the cable is becoming very large, then the communication will become very slow because in bus configuration, the communication always takes place through the common backbone cable only. So the speed of the transmission will become very slow in case the network becomes large with the bus configuration. Now ring topology requires total n number of links to connect n number of nodes in the ring manner. So if we are connecting total n number of devices, let's say 4 devices in ring manner, then we require total n links, these n links to connect them in the ring manner. And there is no privacy in ring configuration also because the message will be passing along the common ring structure. And every device in the ring configuration requires one input output line to get connected to the common backbone ring. It is easy to install and reconfigure or reconnect the devices in the ring configuration. The cost of the ring configuration is moderate. The fault identification in ring configuration is easy because if a device is disconnected from the ring structure, it can be easily identified. If a particular device is not working, then it becomes easy to identify the non-working status of that particular device in ring configuration. Then line configuration used in ring topology is multipoint because every node in this ring topology is connected to multiple nodes. It is terminated at multiple nodes. So multipoint configuration is used in the ring topology. Then ring topology was meant for the IBM token rings. IBM token rings were used long ago, and nowadays the ring topology is not a preferred one in the local area networks. Now let us move on to the Cisco packet tracer to configure these devices, but let me explain you what output is expected from this experiment. You have to configure the topologies, you have to configure the IP addresses on each of the devices, and you have to test the connectivity between each of the devices using that particular topology, and then you have to include the ping responses for each of the topology, and you have to include the packet flow sequences. You have to write down the packet flow sequences. For example, the packet is moving from one computer to a switch first, then switch to another switch and another computer likewise. So you have to write down the packet flow sequences from the observed animation in the Cisco packet tracer. Now let us move on to the Cisco packet tracer to configure the topologies.